Have actually shared three major concepts here regarding the reopening. The education sector is not much important than our economic sector, and no country can survive without economic development or movement. And also you shared the concept of home learning and hybrid schooling system. And also you suggested in the end of your response about, you know, bridge year, to fix this year as a neutral year, and after then we will wait till all the things are set, and after then we'll reopen in the second year. Okay, anyways, it is somehow you know, opening some new dimensions of our thought process, and we will eagerly waiting for the directions of MHRD and central government. Yes, you are telling about, you know, we have to be away from the virus, and we have to marry the virus, living with virus. Then what would be the situation? And people feel irritated in using masks, you know, whenever they get outside, and they cannot keep this much social distancing all the time. Parents are getting panic and extra cautious on health of their wards in social distancing and these things. Then how can we go on with this precautions to 1 year or 2 year, or what would be the lots of misconceptions are spreading out among the society and social media. People are their own doctors, people are their own experts, people are judging, and they are producing. Then how can you, sir, think about the concept of living with virus?
Very good question. You know, the question, if you ask a very simple question, straight pointed one, when will be complete normality? Yes. When can we really start? I think the answer to that is very simple. When we have a safe environment, which means until a vaccine is available, and a country like New Zealand, I think they are now opening schools in a big way, because there has been no new case of yes, for the last 2 weeks. Countries like Fiji, countries like similar, smaller countries. So unless there is a completely safe environment, and a completely safe environment will be either there is no virus, or I have a vaccine that's going to protect me. If there is a vaccine that's going to protect me, I don't mind mixing with people. Both these situations, in the true sense, nobody is able to predict. One can make a guess that maybe in the US there could be a vaccine available, but a vaccine being available does not mean it will be completely protective. It could be protective, it may not be protective. But as I said, in India, it's not 100% guaranteed that the vaccine in the US will be working in vaccine in India. And that is another reason to worry. So unless we have a very safe environment, I don't think, and that could be months and it could be years, even for sure, it's going to be months from now. So how do we live with the virus? I think we have to live with the virus by following. Whenever we deal with the places where we have to meet people, where we have to go to office, where we have to go to school, I think 4 or 5 essential measures have to be taken. And these have to be taken until the virus is circulating in the community. And a country like India, with the 1.3 billion people, plus billion people, a virus will continue to circulate for a long time to come. Not months, but maybe it'll spill over to a year or so, even more. So what do we do? We have to stay with the facility to have a temperature check. We have to continue to wear the mask, whether we like it or not. The wearing a mask is one sure way of not only protecting yourself, but also protecting your people who are next to you. So, you know, you are doing two things together. Maintaining a physical distance. And as I said earlier, it was thought to be 3 feet or 1 meter. Today, the CDC and the published scientific literature says you should maintain a 2 meter distance to be really remain really safe from the virus. Washing hands. Now, we can wear the mask, We can do temperature checks. Digital temperatures are infrared temperatures are very easy, not very expensive also. You can maintain physical distance. But washing hand, how many of us can do it? And what do we do? Instead, take the easier route, use a sanitizer. Don't forget, sanitizers have things that kill the virus. And this also has chemicals that can cause injury to you silently over a period of time. So lesser and lesser use of hand sanitization is advisable. Best is to use washing, soap washing. Soap washing is the best way. Wash for at least 20 seconds. This means count till 20 every second, one second. And then you can wash it off. I think this is one thing. And of course, sanitization of the place. Now, how do the colleges and universities, what they need to do? They have to now catch up with the lost time. They have to figure out what are the learning losses. You know, I work for an institution known as Jamia Hamdard. We have been able to complete all our courses. We have been able to complete the exams for the last semester. But let me tell you, online education is not the same as a classroom education. I know that you have a separate question on online education. But we have to now get used to a combination of virtual learning and a classroom learning, even in the universities. We cannot have, there are many reasons for that, and I'll come back to these reasons as we move to the next question. So school learning in a block of days, or college or university of classroom learning for a particular group, and do non-classroom learning, virtual learning. In fact, today, we will be seeing more and more of virtual learning and more of anytime learning, all-time learning and anytime learning. And that can happen because of classroom learning, because of non-availability of classroom learning. You know, while I'm speaking, I can't see you. You also perhaps can't see me. The pleasure is not the same unless we have an eye-to-eye contact. Online learning cannot be, that will never be equal to classroom learning. Never be equal to, but then we have no other option. So we have to strike a balance between these. And also there's another problem. The problem is many of our teachers, I would say 99% of our teachers are used to classroom learning, classroom teaching. So they will have to unlearn this method of classroom teaching and relearn and learn the method of online teaching. It's a very different ballgame altogether. So there are complex issues.